Dominica is home to the last remaining settlement of the indigenous people of the Caribbean, the Kalinago. Today, approximately 3,000 Kalinagos inhabit a 3,700-acre territory on the eastern coast of Dominica, known as the Carib Territory. The territory, also referred to as the Carib Reserve, is well known for showcasing the rich culture, art, and craft of its people. As well as some of the most breathtaking scenery on the rugged Atlantic coastline. For many years, the island's original inhabitants, not unlike other indigenous populations around the world, have been disenfranchised and often marginalized from the rest of society. Today, the government of Dominica has taken several steps to bridge the gap which once existed by promoting integration as well as ameliorating the standard of living of the Kalinago people. In 2000, the first ever Minister for Carib Affairs, Kelly Grano, was appointed as a Member of Parliament to represent the indigenous community and oversee matters of direct interest to the Kalinago people. Following its membership with the Bolivarian Alliance for the Americas, ALBA, in 2008, the Roosevelt-Skerrit administration secured a grant of $16 million from Venezuela for major development projects in the Carib Territory. The government has also sought funding from the government of the People's Republic of China for community development projects that will benefit the Kalinago people. Since 2008, the Carib Territory has undergone a major transformation as government seeks to meet the needs of the people by providing adequate and affordable housing, improved road networks, access to quality education, and new and improved sporting facilities. As a result of these projects, increased income and employment opportunities have been provided for a significant number of men and women residing in and around the territory. As part of government's community outreach initiative, Prime Minister Honorable Roosevelt Skerrit and members of cabinet, including Minister for Carib Affairs Honorable Ashton Grano, recently paid a visit to the Salibier constituency. The main purpose of the visit was to review the status of various government-funded projects that have taken place in several hamlets within the Carib Territory, as well as at Kinson and Antrizel, two communities situated on the outskirts of the reserve. The day-long tour was an opportunity for the Prime Minister to have a one-on-one chat with residents in the community. The first stop was at the Sinicu Housing Scheme, a recent development comprising 10 brand new two-bedroom houses for families in need of decent accommodation. As a follow-up from a 1998 report from the Caribbean Development Bank, which revealed that 75% of the houses in the Carib Territory were in poor condition and in need of replacement, the Ministry of Housing has focused its attention on home construction and repairs in that area. Funded by the government of the Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela, the new houses are fitted with a kitchen, dining room, living room, and washroom facilities. Minister responsible for housing, Honorable Reginald Ostry, says residents of the Carib Territory have been placed high on the priority list for new and refurbished homes, given the communal land tenure system that currently exists there.
This government have always held the view that the people of the Carib Territory had to be given special consideration and had to be treated differently. One of the reasons for that being of the land tenure situation in the Carib Territory, where individuals don't own land as such. And you know, in this day and age, the ownership of a piece of land can mean a lot to many people. It can mean higher education, it can mean better housing, and it can mean a long-lasting future. But because of the peculiar situation where land is held in common, the Caribbean people have a difficulty in accessing funding through the traditional means, like for the banks or the credit unions, to improve their livelihood. And this government believes that the Caribbean people are too important to us for us not to give them special attention.
The Prime Minister and his team met with the new homeowners who are now living comfortably with basic utilities such as water and electricity and newly constructed roads to gain access to their homes. The government officials also visited the Maho River housing scheme, where 7 new homes have been built to accommodate families who currently reside in the territory. Government anticipates an additional 4 more houses to be constructed in that area, funded by the government of the People's Republic of China. The cabinet ministers also called at the Sensi housing scheme, where 5 new homes have been erected. Under the Housing Revolution program, the government of Dominica has also attended to the needs of the residents in Bataka, Salibier, and Concord. Through its ALBA fund, designed to assist Latin American and Caribbean countries in their social and economic development, the government of the Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela has financed the first phase of this housing program, which has so far had a significant impact on the social and economic life of the Kalinago people. To date, a total of 41 homes have been built in the Salibier constituency, costing approximately $4.3 million. Housing Minister Honorable Reginald Ostry says government has sympathized with the plight of the residents of the Carib territory, and so many have been given new homes free of charge.
Each of these houses would have cost us somewhere in the region of $110,000, $120,000. But 30 of those houses were given absolutely free, of no charge, to the recipients of those houses. While another 10 were sold to what I consider to be more affluent people, like some public officers and some people who were gainfully and permanently employed. And we sold those houses to them, but at the meager cost of $30,000. So there is this house costing government $120,000. 30 of them were given away completely and totally free, while the additional 11 was sold or offered for sale at the price of $30,000.
An additional 42 homes are expected to be erected in the near future, costing close to $3.3 million, funded by the government of China. With regards to housing repairs, during the period 2009 to 2010, $200,000 was spent on renovating homes within the Carib territory, and a further $56,000 went towards repairing homes in Atkinson in November 2011. This formed part of government's home repair and sanitation program. Honorable Reginald Ostry was part of the contingent touring the Carib territory. He says, despite the government's attempts to improve the living conditions of the Kalinago people, there is still a need to extend the Housing Revolution program in the Salibier constituency.
Having worked for the Carib territory, you realize there's much more work to be done as far as the housing situation is concerned. And I cannot guarantee you that all the issues affecting the Carib people in terms of housing can be addressed in 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 years. It's a tremendous task, but we are determined to keep up, to take up the challenge. And that is why we have gone to the Chinese government and have sought and received funding for additional 42 houses that will be spread across the Carib territory. The locations have been identified. The designs have been completed. That has been approved by the planning department. Contractors have tendered on those projects. Contractors have been selected. And we're hoping that very early next week, we can move towards the signing of those contracts and work will begin in earnest on these 42 houses being funded by the government of China.
The impact of government's Housing Revolution program has been felt throughout the Caribbean.